We've been, in a very short period of time, experienced a massive shift in sentiment from being more positive and constructive to being negative. So even good news is interpreted as negative. And this has occurred in a very, very short period of time. I mean, it's hard to remember, just 5 or 6 weeks ago, we were up 10%. And then with 10 days later, we were down in negative territory, and now we've been everywhere in between.
And Art, you know, P.T. Jones is not the only one that's been calling a bond bubble out there, and he sees that as a worrisome trend at this point. What do you think?
Well, it's interesting. You know, obviously, interest rates being at low for a long time got a lot of corporate borrowing, and, you know, perhaps, you know, when the tide goes out, we're going to find out who's swimming naked. I think, you know, of larger concern in the near term, I think for us is getting China right. And I think that the indications coming out of the administrations and coming out of China right now is we've taken some of those baby steps in that direction. So to me, I think we fix a lot of things that we're concerned about right in the here and now. If we can actually have some concrete evidence that we're trying to get something accomplished with China, that takes some pressure off the dollar. It certainly takes some pressure off the global economy. It certainly takes some inflationary pressure off the Fed, and I think that would drive a lot of positive back in this marketplace. But right now, you know, the messaging has been terrible up until yesterday.
Let's say those things don't happen, Art. What do you do in this market environment?
I would get much more defensive if this is going to be a long, drawn-out, mutually destructive
trade war. Is that what you are doing?
Yeah, well, we've got a higher level of cash in some of our portfolios across the board, but that's been the case since the summertime because we didn't see, you know, much headway getting through. We thought perhaps around midterms or, you know, choreographed around midterm elections, we'd start to get some better news. It appears as though we're heading in that direction. But I would certainly say if you're concerned at this point in time, Melissa, the best thing to do is raise cash. It's not to buy into some of the defensive names that have gotten very expensive like the staples.
What about you, Ron? Go to cash. Defensive, Mike Santoli pointed out how quality issues have been leading the way recently as people rush to the higher quality stocks. What are you doing here?
Yeah, I think I would describe our positioning and our view on markets as constructive. Okay, I think it's the best of the returns are behind us over the last 7 or 8 years, but I do expect a constructive view around the corporate and economic fundamentals over the next year or two. I think it's going to be a very long and elongated economic cycle. And I think the return profile going forward is going to be moderate, and I'll describe that as mid-single digits. But I think it's too early to be overly defensive here. And I think the markets have moved from peak conditions, meaning peak growth, potentially peak earnings, probably peak profit margin, but moving from peak to late cycle to end of cycle to over is a little bit too premature for us, and so we're not getting extremely defensive here. It's a
well,
more conservative.
Well, let's say the extreme of being defensive is cash. There's a huge spectrum in between. So if you're constructive, but it's not optimal conditions, it's no longer Goldilocks for equities.
That's right.
What does that allocation look like?
So it's still modestly underweight fixed. I think we're in an environment where interest rates continue to moderate here or normalize, if you will, and so slow and gradual. I think slow and gradual. From a fixed income standpoint, is a slight underweight. And I think that environment is still constructive for equity or risk assets. And I think you need to be on the more of the high quality side of the equity tree.